Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. Recently, like the last time I asked you guys what you wanted to see for my first video, I asked if I should split up my videos and do one over my eyeshadow and one over my face makeup, and that's what you guys wanted to see. So today I'm going to do a tutorial over just my face makeup. I'm not going to do any eyes or eyebrows or anything like that, just my face makeup. So let's get into it. First, I'm going to prime, and my nose gets really dry, and I like to use this primer. It's like an egg shape thing, and it's called Egg Pour. You can get it at Ulta, I'm pretty sure. It's kind of like a balm, that's what it says on the back. But it looks like this, and you take it apart, and then there's a little orange flap thing on the inside, and you take it out, and it looks like this. So I like to put that on my nose because my nose gets really dry, and it helps my dry skin not look so bad when I put on my foundation. And next, I'm going to prime the rest of my face, and I'm going to use the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. It says it's oil-free, and I like to use it on my T-zone because that's where I get oily throughout the day. I'm going to take this, and I'm going to put it right here, right here, right here, right here, and I'm going to just rub that out with my hands all over the area. Next, I'm going to take my Tarte Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation in the shade Light Sand, and I don't really put it on the back of my hand or anything because of the way that it comes out. If I put it on the back of my hand, then I always end up getting too much. So what I like to do is I like to just put however much I want on my face like this. On my cheeks, on my chin, on my nose, and across my forehead. And I always do a little bit on the sides so that I have enough. And after that, I have another primer that I really like to mix in with my foundation, and you can use it before or after. And it's the Pure No Filter Blurring Photography Primer. It looks like this. So you take it out, and it's like a little dropper thingy, and it's like a white, shiny type of deal. And I just put a drop of it on both my cheeks, on my chin, and on my forehead like that. It makes my foundation look like less matte because I don't like my face to look so dry throughout the day. But that's just what I do there. And I take my damp beauty blender, it's kind of dirty, my apologies, and I kind of like mix the primer in with where I put my foundation first, and then I go back and I blend it all out over my face. After that, I'm going to go ahead and conceal. So I'm going to take the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the shade Light Sand, and I'm going to put that under my eyes, on my forehead, down the bridge of my nose, and on my chin. So I'm just going to take it like this. And I always do like 2 swipes. Some people like to use a lot more concealer than I'm using right now, and that's fine. I just don't need very much because my dark circles aren't that bad. So I'm going to put it on that area of my face. And I like to take a different beauty blender. I'm pretty sure I got this one from Sephora, but it has like a flat edge right here, and I like to use that to go under my eyes and on my nose in like areas like this since they're not very big. So I'm just gonna take it, and it's damp just like the other one was, and I'm going to blend out my concealer. After you are done blending out your concealer, I'm going to take the same beauty blender that I was using before, and I'm taking the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. I already took the lid off, but I just have the little one, it looks like that. And I went ahead and I dumped some into the lid like that, and I'm going to take the flat side of my beauty blender, and I'm going to dip it in to the powder like this, and I'm using this to set my under eyes. So you want to set it before it creases, and if it creases, you can just go back in before you set it with your translucent setting powder, and you can blend out the creases with your damp beauty blender still. So I'm just taking it like that on my beauty blender, taking it under my eyes, and just lightly pressing it into my skin and setting my concealer. After you have set your face, I'm going to take this Morphe brush, It doesn't have a number on it, but it came in the same set of brushes that the last eyeshadow brushes that I used in my last video came in. And I'm going to take some more of the translucent setting powder and dump it into the lid. And I'm going to take the brush and I'm going to just get some on my brush like this. And I'm going to tap a little bit of it off and I'm going to tap it back into the bowl like that. And I'm going to take this and I'm going to use it to set the rest of my face. And you don't want to swirl, you just want to pat. So I'm just patting like this. And I'll do that over all my face. After you are all done setting your face, I'm going to go ahead and bronze. So what I like to use for bronzer is this Too Faced. It came in the, like this one's called the Gingerbread Cookie Palette. And it came with this one, it's called the Peppermint Mocha Palette. And there's one more other palette. And it was like a limited edition thing for Christmas, like 2 years ago, I think. I don't know. But I'm going to take this shade down here, and it's called Gingerbread. And I'm going to take it on this Real Techniques brush right here. It looks like this. And I'm just going to dip right into that shade right there, like that. Tap off the excess. And I'm going to go on my cheekbones and bronze. After you have bronzed your cheekbones, I'm going to dip back into the same gingerbread shade from that gingerbread cookie palette from Too Faced. And I'm just going to get a little bit on there. And I don't really bronze my forehead a lot, but I do a little bit so that it goes with the other, like, colors of my face. And I just take a little bit and go around the edges of my forehead like this. Very light-handed because I don't want it to be super dark because I don't have a big forehead, so I don't really need to make it look smaller. So I'm just going to take it around the edges of my forehead like this. And then I'm going to take whatever's left on the brush and just go down these sides of my nose like that. And on my jawline just a little bit like that. After you are done bronzing all of your face, I'm going to take a brush from the same Morphe set that I've been using. It looks like this. And I'm going to dip into my Kat Von D Shade and Light Contour Palette. And it's just powders, and it looks like this. And I like to dip into this middle shade right here. And I only do like one or two taps in the color. And then I tap a lot of it off because it is very pigmented. And I'm going to take this brush, holding it like this. I'm going to go like down the sides of my cheekbones like that, and then I'm going to blend it upwards so that it's not just a harsh line like that. And after you are done contouring your cheekbones, I'm going to take the tiniest bit of that same shade on this same Morphe brush, tap off the excess, and go very lightly around the edges of my forehead like I did before. After you are done contouring your forehead, I'm going to go into blush, and the blush I'm going to use today is from that same Christmas set as the other that I used for my bronzer, and it's called the Peppermint Mocha Palette, and the shade I'm going to use is called Santa Baby, and it's this one down here at the bottom. The other palette that comes in the set is this one right here, and it's called the Eggnog Latte Palette. I don't know if this set is still for sale. I don't think it would be because it did come out like probably a year and a half or 2 years ago. But there's another blush in this set and it's called Peach Cobbler. I like this one more for in the summertime, but since we're still in the winter, I like to use this one called Santa Baby. So I'm going to take this blush on this Real Techniques Bold Metals brush. That's like the set that it came from. It looks like this, and I'm going to dip into this shade right here, like that, tap off the excess, and you're going to want to go on the apples of your cheeks and just a little bit back, and I like to use blush. You definitely don't have to use blush, and a lot of people don't like to use blush, but I do because I think it makes my face look more, like, cohesive. I feel like if I don't wear blush, then I just look like a flat pancake, and I don't like the way it looks. So I'm going to take that shade, Santa Baby, on this Real Techniques blush brush, and put it on the apples of my cheeks like this. After you are done with your blush, I'm going to go ahead and do the last step of my face makeup, which is highlighter. And I'm going to take the highlighter from Becca, and it's the one with Jaclyn Hill, and it's called Champagne Pop, and it's a really pretty gold color like this. I don't know if you guys can see it very good, but that's what it looks like, and it's gold. And I have two highlighting brushes that I really like, and one of them is this fan brush from Morphe in the same set that came as the other ones, and another one is honestly just this little brush that came from Ulta in this bag of like samples that I got. It says that it's for blush, but it's really small, and I like to use it for highlighting. So today I'm going to use the one from Ulta. And before I do my highlighter, I always like to spray my face with some MAC Fix Plus. So that's what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to spray my face. I'm going to let it dry a little bit, and then I'm going to put on some
After
of my
you
highlighter.
Let that dry for a little bit, just like a couple seconds, I'm going to take this highlighter, and I'm going to take this brush, and I'm going to dip into it just like that.
And I'm just going to do like a little tap on my finger because I don't want very much of it to come off, because I like my highlight to be in everybody's face because that's my favorite part of my makeup. So after I dip into my highlight, you're just going to put it on the tops of your cheekbones, and I go a little bit up the side. I put a little bit above my eyebrows, like the arch of my eyebrows, down my nose, and on my Cupid's bow. So I'm going to take that, like I'm going to take Champagne Pop on this brush, and I'm going to do on my cheekbones like this, up the sides a little bit, just dip back in. Do the same thing.
And then I like to just
take some of it on my pinky to do the bridge of my nose because I don't really like to use a brush for it. So I'm just going to take some of it on my pinky like that. And I'm going to go on the tip of my nose like this. And then down the middle or like the bridge of my nose. And it looks really, really like not blended at all. So I'm going to take the end of this beauty blender. And you can take any beauty blender you want and just blend it out a little bit like that. And then I like to do the same thing for my Cupid's bow, dip in with my finger just a little bit and go over the top like that so that I have some on my Cupid's bow. I forgot to bake, so like bake my contour, so that's what I'm going to go ahead and do before I'm done. I'm going to take the same Laura Mercier translucent setting powder and put some in the lid. I'm going to take that same flat beauty blender from Sephora, dip into it like that. I'm going to it's just to like clean up your contour, so I'm just going to go under my contour and like kind of to the edge of my mouth so that it's not so messy like this. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. This just to clean up the underneath of my
Hi guys, I am back with the finished face makeup look. This is how I do like the base, like my foundation, my concealer, contour, blush, highlighter, everything like that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Once again, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thank you for watching. Make sure to give it a thumbs up before you leave, and I'll see you guys next week on Thursday. I also, once again, have my Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat in the description below. And I'll also put below the products that I use so that you guys can get them if you want them. But send me ideas on Instagram or Twitter or Snapchat if you'd like, so I know what you guys want to see in next week's video. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back again on Thursday.